Economists believe the dairy industry is headed for a rebound. A Washtenaw County Farm Bureau committee is receiving national recognition for the second year in a row. And Michigan Agricultural Commodities' Chris Betts has your market report. I'm Janelle Bros, and this is Farm News 5.
Farm News 5 is brought to you by Ford.
It may take a while for Michigan's dairy industry to rebound from several down years on the markets. But Chris Wolf with the Dyson School of Applied Economics and Management at Cornell University believes 2019 is the beginning of a recovery that will continue throughout 2020.
This has been the beginnings of a recovery. If you look at the average U.S. milk prices, we started off the year class 3 and class 4 in that $14 hundredweight range, which is below, you know, cost of production for virtually everyone. And then throughout the year, it's been kind of slowly gaining momentum to where we're at the point where November class 3, as of close yesterday, was $19.10 a hundredweight, which is a very respectable class 3 price on the strength of $2 a pound cash cheese prices. And so it's looking like there's some momentum on the dairy markets at this point in time for the first time in a while. Futures markets expect are projecting something in the $17.50 range for class 4 and a little bit less than that for class 3, maybe $17.20, $17.25. At the current time, that's given what we know at the current time, and lots of things can happen, weather events, trade disputes, other things like that. But I think that there's even still potentially some upside in the market. I think that we're due for a recovery year. We've had a lot of farms go out of business. You know, in 2018, it was over 13% of licensed dairy herds in the state of Michigan went out of business. That's a lot. The long-term exit rate is more like 4%, so we're tripling that, and you know, 2019 may be more of the same. We can only do that for so long before we need to start to see some recovery.
The state of Michigan continues to hold a place on the milk production per cow leaderboard. The USDA's National Ag Statistics Service reported earlier this week that Michigan dairy cows, on average, produced 72.2 pounds of milk per day during the month of September. Almost 8.5 pounds more per day than the average across the 24 major milk-producing states. The question now becomes, can the state's dairy cows continue to be some of the most efficient in the country, with uncertainty about forage quality and availability?
Historically, milk production per cow increases 1.5% to 2% a year, kind of regardless of what seems to happen through management changes, through genetics, through nutrition, through other management changes. And it's kind of amazing. It's an amazing success story, I think, kind of how successful the U.S. producers have been in just increasing milk production per cow. I think there's going to be some real challenges in this next year as the forage quality and expenses change. We've had, this past summer, not great weather for forages in a large part of the country. It's been hard to get them off. And the forages that have been made have not been super high quality in a lot of cases. And I think that when we start to run short on forages, and high quality hay that you need for a high producing dairy cow gets expensive, I think we're gonna see a real effect potentially on milk per cow, and that's where it's gonna show up in the milk supply response. Perhaps when we start getting into March, we're gonna start to see that bite. Expenses are gonna go up. High quality hay is gonna be hard to find. There's already some situations where straw is getting more expensive because you can substitute that fiber to some extent in the dairy ration. And that's when I think we're gonna start to feel it.
Wolf's comments were made October 23rd during the annual Michigan Agriculture Credit Conference, which brings together agricultural lenders, agribusinesses, and policymakers for updates on the agriculture economy in Michigan.
If you want a car from a company that's been building them for 115 years, get a Ford. If you want a car with driver assist technology, get a Ford. You're gonna want a Ford.
It's a two-peat for the Washtenaw County Farm Bureau's Promotion and Education Committee, which has again been chosen as an exhibitor in the American Farm Bureau Federation County Activities of Excellence Showcase.
So this is our second year doing our Treat of Agriculture event. It's a trick-or-treating event of Michigan agriculture products. So we actually really focus on non-candy items. So we have things like apples and honey sticks and flower stickers to represent all different kinds of commodities from throughout Michigan. Our county has been selected to be part of the County Activities of Excellence Award to be showcased at the American Farm Bureau annual meeting. This is our second year, which is really exciting and an honor to be part of that. There's only a, You apply with the event that you have done from throughout the year, and then there's a selection process that you go through. So we're really honored to be selected to showcase this awesome event that we've done as AFBF comes up this next year.
The Michigan Senate passed Farm Bill-backed legislation this week that's considered the first major rewrite of the state's livestock laws in 20 years. The multi-bill package includes a measure implementing cage-free hen standards by 2025, aligning state law with national industry standards. Animal industry stakeholders, lawmakers, and state agency experts have spent the better part of 2 years working to update and modernize the law to improve provisions related to biosecurity, disease outbreak response, and livestock indemnification standards. The legislation now moves to the Michigan House for consideration.
Harvest season is a prime time for accidents. Educate your operators before they hit the road. Check out available resources at fosterswift.com/ag-transportation.
Michigan State University is conducting an industrial hemp survey to ensure research and extension efforts will benefit growers. Individuals or companies who have grown or are interested in growing industrial hemp are invited to complete the online survey. Participation is voluntary and responses will be kept confidential. The survey can be found at the MSU Extension Industrial Hemp website. And now with a look at the latest market activity, here is Michigan Ag Commodities' Chris Betts.
Thanks, Janelle. A more subdued tone this week as harvest lent pressure on corn and beans. Good progress will have been made with drier weather, although a freeze remains a concern for late developing crops. Weather in Brazil has also stayed more favorable for planting there, which have also weighed on trade. Rumors are still circulating around Chinese purchase of U.S. soybeans as part of the latest reported mini-deal between the U.S. and China. However, trade has been unimpressed of late, with the surge in soybeans stalling out over the last 2 weeks. The local basis for corn and beans is feeling support as harvest continues to drag out, forcing end users to pay up to cover needs ahead of new crop bushels coming their way. Chances for rain continue through the weekend and into next week, which should keep basis firm. For more market information, go to michag.com. With Michigan Agricultural Commodities, I'm Chris Betts.
For more news and video, visit michiganfarmnews.com and the Michigan Farm Bureau channel on YouTube. With Farm News 5, I'm Janelle Bros. Have a great week of farming.